everybody. My name is David Pegler. This is your preliminary outlook for June the 10th, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you the purpose of FX Bootcamp's education. This is non-alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what we will do is conduct some fundamental and tactical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good positive trade plans. Please bear in mind when you're trading heavily leveraged, this leverage will occasionally work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, it has a nasty way of working against you, so please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. Okay, folks, well, 2 days in a row, you know, we've either got lucky or it's been through some decent technical analysis. This pound trade worked out pretty much exactly how we anticipated yesterday. If you remember, our little trade plan was a short down to support and the fib of the rise, because this is a pound 4 hour chart I'm showing you. If you take a look at the daily, we're bouncing off this 21 EMA, and what often happens is that you go up, you hit resistance, you get a little bit of selling, and then it comes down to a fib of the little rise, and that higher low confirms that there's upside. And how I instructed members at FX Bootcamp to trade this, if I just go to the 15 very quickly, is that the first sign of a higher low was our confirmation that there was a change in sentiment, and then we broke this previous swing high, came up, retested it, and the rest was long. You know, we were long for the rest of the day, and really, you know, although the 15 minute was the chart of execution, we're playing 4 hour bounces of support and resistance and this all important daily 21 EMA bounce. So, you know, sometimes you get lucky on these things and they work out as you anticipate, right? Well, now, today I would actually like to take a look at the euro dollar. And it's in much the same kind of position that the pound is in many respects. You know, although we breached it, this is a daily euro chart, we're bouncing off this 21 EMA effectively. And on the daily, you'll notice that we're still making a series of higher lows and higher highs. So on a daily level, you still got to be bullish. However, there is, you know, we had this little 4 hour head and shoulders up here. Okay, I'm showing you a daily chart that broke, broke its neckline, made its little projection. But there is a possibility that there's going to be some people watching a complex head and shoulders here. Okay, in which case then we're going to see much more downside. Okay, so the conundrum today is really trying to solve this puzzle. All right, which one is going to win out? Are the shorts at these previous highs, take a look at all these wicks up top here, are those shorts going to win out, meaning the roll reversal going to win out, or are people trying to long this in alignment with the prevailing daily trend at support? And folks, frankly, my bias is still to the upside given this daily move, but I'm not stubborn enough that if it tries to roll over, I'm not going to put myself in a position too long. And I'll tell you what I mean. All right, if we just take a look at the power, this is that resistance area that I was talking about, which we have now bounced off of. And even if we make a little higher high here, I think it's possible that we're going to come back down and retest this 140 level. And that is going to be the true test, folks. I expect to find buyers here at this 140. And then if we make a lower high at this right shoulder, say below 141, if we make a lower high below 141, then I think that the short side is now possible. Also, the stock market is in a very intriguing spot to me. If the market wants to head down, then, you know, the dollar is going to gain some strength. So keep an eye on the market, because at the moment it's been trapped between its weekly 5 and its weekly 200 EMA, and we've got to resolve that little range that we've made for ourselves. So, you know, look out for clues on the stock market and look out for clues on the stock market to help you with these, with the dollar. But, you know, I am still bullish on the dollar, and if we're going to break above 141, it's hard to get bearish. And frankly, I'm looking to long again at this 140 level in alignment with the support, looking for much higher, maybe even as high as 145 over the next few days. But, you know, below 141, there's a lot of people are going to see that as a complex head and shoulder short. Above it is bullish, and frankly, I'd like to see a little lower high here and Asian retracement back to support and then continuation. Okay, that's what I'm looking at today, folks. Nothing fancy there at all. Basic support and resistance stuff. The yen trade and trend following type trade plans. The yen trade that we looked at yesterday is also working out pretty nicely. Okay, if you remember, we had this little price trap, and price effectively broke it, came up, retested, and is now short, and looks like it absolutely wants a piece of this hourly 200 EMA, you know, down that, say, 96.90, another 40 pips down. So the yen crosses are going to be a little tougher to trade, but, you know, stick with the USD, and I think you're going to be just fine in this market. So, you know, that's been your pre-London outlook for June the 10th, 2009. Take it easy, everybody. I'll catch you tomorrow.